I think healthcare data, there's two things, right? One is the data access. When I talk about interoperability, there's syntactic, semantic, and technical interoperability. So health data today, as we, you know, multiple different EMRs, and that's why standards like FHIR are important, right? That part is interoperable. Because there's still healthcare has data in PDFs. It's in documents. It's in clinical unstructured notes. So I believe that's where the power of AI and machine learning comes in. Can we convert that data, which is unstructured, living in the faxes, living in the PDFs, and convert it from unstructured to structured, and then that can be interoperable?
I think interoperability, you have to look at it from sort of the nuts and bolts of, are you actually having the data sets that allow you to be able to understand and combine them into different manners, and some of which is, we already have structured data that's not interoperable. We need to figure out ways to make that more interoperable with some of the standards that we have today. There is that fourth level of interoperability, which is at the system level, and it's about policy. And it's about allowing us to be able to understand how these different systems, these interoperability systems, will play. Are we standardized on specific ones? And it really isn't until, you know, everyone always says, I love standards because everyone has one. Well, what we need to do is we need to standardize on the single standard for how we make healthcare data interoperable, specific for particular types of data sets.
But we've had the capability of shifting care to a more consumer-centric, consumer-relevant environment for years. And the barriers to that, I would argue, are not technology. They're more cultural, and they're about how we pay for care. So there's been a lot we could do differently for a very long time, but it's only now in the moment of crisis during COVID, for example, that we're seeing some of those walls break down. We're getting that push that we need to push care into an environment that's actually more relevant to the consumer. I'm glad for that, but I don't want to mistake that for a technology evolution. It's actually a cultural and financial evolution.